Hey, Michael Church, Crawlspace Ninja. I'm here with HB Marshall from YCS, and I have asked HB to share with everybody what exactly is the deal with perm rating. It's not something that's easy to explain, and HB, his company does manufacture vapor barrier and mold cleaners, so I thought, who else to explain perm rating other than a vapor barrier manufacturer? So HB, take it away. Tell us what perm rating
is. Yeah, thanks, Michael. Yeah, we do. We've been designing and making products for crawl spaces for golly, almost 25 or 30 years now. And one of the questions that we get all the time is around perm rating. It's one of those topics that kind of cringe when you hear it, but I think it's important to understand what perm rating means. And I think that's the biggest issue, is that there's a lot of talk about perm rating, but does the average consumer actually know what perm rating means?
Right?
So perm rating essentially measures the rate at which vapor moisture can transmit through a solid surface, right?
Right.
But what does that mean? We see perm ratings at, you know, 0.00 or 0.000 or 0.08 or 0.04. A lot of building professionals understand classification. So class A, class B, class C, which relates to perm rating or permeability of a vapor barrier. But what does that all mean to the consumer, to the end user? Because that's what matters, right? What does that mean to the person that's purchasing the finished product? So the difference in a 0.00 perm and a 0.08, which would be a, or 0.06, a class A vapor barrier product, the difference in real life application is going to be essentially 1 teaspoon of water over a 24-hour period over 1,000 square feet.
Oh, wow.
Right? So that's the delta in a 0.000, a pool liner, and a 0.08 or a 0.06. And we're 90% of the time on a crawl space project where perm rating is being emphasized, we're installing a dehumidifier that does what, Michael? 50, 70, 100 pints of moisture per day that's capable of extracting that volume of water. So the delta in a 0.0 and a 0.06 or 0.08 in real life is fairly minimal.
Right. And there's different people pushing, you know, mill and perm rating and all that stuff that again, the dehumidifier is more than capable of taking care of. What we try to emphasize is a very durable crawl space vapor retarder versus mill or anything else, because there are some, you know, there's some companies out there pushing 100 mil vapor barriers, right? Mm-hmm. And all they are is a bunch of lower mill quality products pushed together that could trap moisture over time because of how they delaminate or things like that. That's why we prefer a solid or a woven type of vapor barrier. Would you agree with that?
I'd agree.
Yeah. So one of the things you want to make sure of is that, will that vapor barrier delaminate? We've done many, many vapor barrier videos and different things. But real quick, tell us, you said class A, class one, class A vapor retarder. Like, I had a gentleman ask me on one of our questions, can I install, you know, roof felt in my crawl space? Well, technically, I looked it up. Roof felt, I believe, is a class 3 or a class C vapor barrier. So according to building code, that would not be a good product to install, because you're required to install a class 1. Is that correct?
Correct.
Yeah. So you want to make sure that you're installing the right class of vapor barrier. Is perm rating important? Probably. Yeah. But if you got a dehumidifier going, it's not as important. Don't let somebody sell you something. Real quick, tell us a little bit about how these perm ratings come about. Is this something that's done in a lab under optimal conditions? How do they get these perm ratings?
Yeah, and that's another thing. There's a couple different test methods. There's ASTM E96, which is a pretty standard. Some test methods are used to design, or excuse me, they're used to test vapor barriers that lay on above ground, on mm-hmm. flat surfaces. Some are used to test vapor barriers that are going under concrete. So it depends. They're all done in a lab. There's a few different test methods. Sort of depends on what the application of the product is going to be, generally determines how they're going to test it. But there could be some manipulation of the data. Of course, you can test a product that's going to be used above ground as if it were going to go under a slab, and vice versa. So it's important, if you're going to lean into the data, that you know what you're reading.
Right. So if perm rating is your only concern, the point of this video is to let you know that there are other factors that you should consider when choosing a vapor barrier,
correct.
Right? So I'm Michael Church, here with HB Marshall from Crawlspace Ninja. He is with YCS. We hope you make it a happy and blessed day, and we'll see you later.